Hello and welcome. Next, I am planning to show you that how you could change this Ford Mondeo's front brake pads and how it happened. First step is that you lift up this your Mondeo, and I have used here this jack, and then it's also good that you insert some wooden lock thickened below of this car, because it's like security, because sometimes, actually quite often, like 5% of those deaths happens so that this car collapse to this repairman who is repairing this car below of this car body, and then we continue this brake pads change. Next, you must to take this front tire out, and I have already opened these bolts, and there is that kind of bolts what you need to open, and they are in here, and then we take this tire out. And there is then this front brake disc and pads. And then it's good that you rotate this disc in that direction, because then it's more easier to open these bolts what are in here back. And there are two of those bolts, and this bolt size is 13 millimeter is this socket size what you need to insert there, this 13, and you insert this your tool. There are two bolts. First one is in here, and you insert this wrench in here, and then you start to open. It opens so, and then there is other bolt what is in this lobe area in here, and you insert also this bolt in there, and you open that, and then the next step is to take this caliper out, and first we need to take those two bolts in here, and here are those bolts, two pieces, and then in same time you take your hands in here, little bit move that in this direction, and in that way, and then you can get more space to this cylinder, and then it opens so nicely, and then you can set up this cylinder in here. There is this cylinder's nice place. Cylinder, it is just now in there. I move it in here. Okay, and then next step is to take those brake pads out, and brake pads are in here, and normally they open very easily in that you only lift this little bit, and this was the first one, and this is the brake pad, and this is actually brand new, and then this is like a noise resistant plate. And its message is to, it is important part, and it resists noise. And then we insert that in there. And then this next is a little bit different, and we need, I use my socket, I insert that in here and then I knap a little bit. And then this that opens too. And there is also this brake pads and this noise. Okay, and then we check this amount. And there should be this braking material at least a couple of millimeter. Sometimes there can be only 1 millimeter, and then this steel comes to be like brake pad, and then it's really noisy. I have tested that couple of times, but brakes even works, but it is not good. And in here we can see that there is almost 1 centimeter, and they are full, almost brand new pads. And then it's good to insert in that area little bit copper pasta, and also those bolts when we install these brake pads back. I have here this copper pasta, and I insert that little bit in here. In that way, this meaning is that there is no rusty. And then I insert, don't put this pasta in these pads, only this opposite side, and also in this part, put I in here, and then in here, in this way. Then you can insert this pad in back, and there is idea that you need a little bit press this, and now when I press it, I do same in here, and these pads are similar in both sides. And first I insert this copper pasta in here, and then those upper areas, that this is like lubricant. And this copper pasta, this can last 1000 Celsius temperature. And then I insert that in, it goes in only one way, not it is possible to put in this way, only one way, and first in this down area, and then up, and then little bit, you need to little bit press, because there are those springs. You need to little bit press this, and now it's back, and then I install this caliper back, and then this caliper installation is so that you sometimes might need to move this cylinder in opposite side, because if you are really old and worn pads, this caliper comes in here, and then you need to take some tool, and you need to press this cylinder back in there, or then you can use tool what I showed to you. You can use that kind of tool, and you insert this in here, and then you press this caliper back in there. And now this caliper is back, and then I can install this cylinder caliper back, and it goes in that way. It goes there nicely. And then we have here those bolts, and we can also insert these bolts, this copper pasta, and then they they are longer. There is no, they are easy to open. And this was the first, first, and then I install this second tool. And then we need to tighten these bolts. And there is some special moment. And I go to take my moment tool, and soon we do this moment tightening next. Okay, and next we need that kind of moment tool, and there is moment something like 40. I use amount for this 40 newton meter, and there is this newton meter and 40 is this amount, and then I go to tighten these bolts. I insert this tool in there and when this clicks and keep sound, then this moment is enough. Okay, and now this tool makes sound, and this moment tighten is enough. You can also use your hand, but there is of course risk that this bolt can go broken, but you can leave without this moment tool, but this moment tool is really really nice tool, because then we know that those bolts are and now this system says that the bolts are in right tighten. Okay, and now we have changed and checked those brake pads, and also we have inserted this copper pasta what makes good lubrication, and also it is very anti-rust. There is no rust now, and then we can insert this tire back, and this work is done. And thank you.